What is up, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and the content that you guys have been waiting for is back. We're back talking about your favorite team, my favorite team, and your mom's favorite team, the Jacksonville Jaguars. Now, we're about a week or two into free agency. The Jaguars have made multiple moves, some good, some mediocre. I honestly wouldn't say any move that they made was terrifically horrid. I think there was a lot of good depth signing and a lot of good starting potential for some players that they have signed in free agency. Now, this also says a lot on what the Jaguars are going to do in the draft. A lot of the signees for the Jaguars, in fact, you know, basically all of them were defensive players. So I think that means in the draft, the Jags are going to try and focus more on the offensive side of the ball. But we're going to be grading each and every free agent signing today in this video. So without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, this is Jaguars Free Agency Grades, Part 1. The trade for Nick Foles for a 4th-round pick to Chicago Bears, A+. Now, I said we were just going to be talking about free agency signings, but this was such a big deal that I really wanted to touch on it more. The fact that the Jaguars were able to finesse the Chicago Bears to trade Nick Foles away for a 4th-round pick is amazing. And the Jags now only have to pay Nick Foles, I believe, this year and maybe next year. It's either just this year or just this year and next year, which is huge. And it doesn't take that big of a hit on the Jaguars' salary cap. You know, a lot of people had a problem with where the cap situation was in Jacksonville, but after all these signings and trades, the Jags' cap space has freed up a ton of space, and the Nick Foles trade was kind of the biggest one. Now, Calais Campbell and A.J. Boye were also traded, and some of the casualties of that, but that kind of happened earlier on in the free agency period, so I felt like Nick Foles was really the only one that was timely to talk about. And the Bears fans are trying to trick themselves into thinking that this is a good deal for them. You know, Nick Foles is not what you want in a quarterback right now. Sure, he won a Super Bowl, but I mean, that's the Philadelphia Eagles. When you put Nick Foles in an Eagles uniform, that's where he shines. He's not really going to shine anywhere else, and he's proved that time and time again when he's gone and played for other teams. Was he injured when he played for us? Sure. But I mean, he still was not the quarterback that we wanted him to be, and Gardner Minshew really stepped up and took the team by the horns and led that Jaguar team. So I think the trade for Nick Foles for a 4th-round draft pick was a tremendous move by this front office and this organization, so an A+ for that move. Joe Schobert, A+. Joe Schobert, I was so excited to get the news that the Jaguars signed Joe Schobert, because Barnage, who's in the crew cast, Barnhouse Productions, you've probably heard of him. He is a huge Cleveland Browns fan, and one of the players that he always hypes up is Joe Schobert. I think the Browns were silly to let him go. He was a defensive leader. He was a man on the field that just got the job done. He's very, very smart, has a lot of football smarts on the field. And you've seen his interview when he came to Jacksonville, and he said he's not a rah-rah guy. He's just a guy that leads by example. And I think that's what the Jaguars need at this point, is somebody that leads by example. I think Gardner Minshew could kind of handle all that rah-rah, you know, stuff, because, you know, that's kind of the player he is. And with the Jags losing Calais Campbell, they kind of lost that in the locker room. So Gardner Minshew should take that. And then Joe Schobert's going to be a great leader on this Jaguar defense. He's very, very talented in all facets of the game that you want a linebacker to be talented in. He's good in pass coverage. He's good at blitzing. He's good at reading the run. He's good in every facet of the way. And the Jags really need a solid middle linebacker in the middle. That's a true middle linebacker. And it also gives Miles Jack a chance to go back to the outside linebacker, which is where a lot of people feel he's more naturally fitted anyway. So that's going to be interesting to see Miles Jack over there. And I'm very excited Joe Schobert is among the Jacksonville Jaguars, so I'm going to be giving that signing an A+. DeQuise Denard, I did not expect this one. I expected if the Jaguars were going to target a corner, it was going to be in the draft somewhere in the late rounds, but I mean, they really do need somebody that's going to try and make an impact right away. Obviously, the Jags have guys like Trey Herndon, DJ Hayden, and now DeQuise Denard. Denard's always kind of been more of a slot corner, a nickel corner, but he's going to be able to compete for that outside corner job opposite of Trey Herndon. And I like it. You know, he has great PFF ratings, and, you know, looking at his stats from when he was with Cincinnati, he was one of their best defensive players. So in order for us to get him, you know, that's a big, big deal, especially when the secondary is something that the Jaguars really need to improve. Is he going to fix it completely? I don't know about that. That's a big maybe, you know, like, because this Jaguars secondary is something that they really need to fix. So, DeQuist Denard, I'm going to give that a B signing for that signing. I think that he's going to have an opportunity to compete and see a lot of playing time, but is he going to be that big of a difference maker? I don't think so. But I think a solid all-around signing for the Jacksonville Jaguars for sure. All right, these next two signings I'm going to combine in one take. Al Woods and Rodney Gunter. Both of them true nose tackle, you know, type of players that plug up the middle and can stop the run game. One thing the Jaguars missed last year was Marcell Dareus. And Marcell just, you know, unfortunately was getting a little bit up there in age and kind of took up a lot of the cap space. So the Jaguars went out and got Gunter and Woods, two guys that are great inside. Gunter's more of an outside player. I think he's going to be kind of the player that replaces Calais Campbell as like that big end spot. But he's really good against the run. Al Woods, a true nose tackle, and is also really good against the run. So, you know, they're going to need some run defenders in there. And having Joe Schobert in the middle, I think, really, really helps these two defensive linemen out tremendously. And it's going to be a weird look to see who really the defensive ends are. Obviously, if Yan doesn't play, Josh Allen will be in. I think DeJuan Smoot's going to have an opportunity to compete for that other starting defensive end position, probably with Gunter, but... You know, as far as the down lineman goes, you know, on first and second down, I think Gunter and Al Woods are going to be two guys that are going to be tremendous players for the Jaguars inside the trenches. So I'm giving both of those guys a B grade as far as that signing goes. I think that I think it'll be all right. And the other two I'm going to join into one are Cassius Marsh and Rashawn Melvin. I think both of these guys, Rashawn Melvin, I think, just won't make the roster. He's going to be able to compete because, like I said, the secondary in Jacksonville is kind of weak and is one of their weaker spots that they have on the defense. I think Cassius Marsh, if anything, is going to be a special teams player. I don't think he's going to be a guy that, regularly sees the field. I think that's kind of what he was in Arizona, was a special teams guy, you know, kickoff, kick return, things like that. So, you know, adding some depth on the special teams, I guess, is a good thing. But I don't expect too much for either one of these two. So keeping it short and sweet, giving this a C-plus grade for those two guys. And the last and final free agent to grade for the Jaguars is tight end Tyler Eifert. The Jags signed Tyler Eifert. Now, this is a couple of years too late. I think the Jags should have got kind of a big-name tight end 2-3 years ago. But, you know, they kind of waited on it. And Tyler Eifert's kind of injury-prone, kind of similar to a lot of Jaguar tight ends, either currently or in the past. You know, Mercedes Lewis had some injury issues. Julius Thomas. You know, James O'Shaughnessy, unfortunately, got hurt last year. And James O'Shaughnessy was a guy that I was kind of excited to see play next year. But Tyler Eifert's never going to be a bad player. He's never going to be a guy you complain about. And I think, you know, if him and Gardner can develop that chemistry, and obviously, you know, he's worked with Jay Gruden before in Cincinnati. So if they can develop that chemistry and Gardner can get the ball to him, that's going to be a duo, and that's going to be a duo to watch out for. I'm hoping Tyler Eifert can kind of not revitalize his career, but maybe, you know, go to the playoffs and maybe get past the first round for the first time in his career. You know, a lot of people have doubts about this Jaguar team. They have the lowest over-under win total heading into the 2021 season. And is that 4.5 wins? I think that's way too low. I think I bet the mortgage on the over on that one because I think the Jags have, you know, added a lot of key pieces. And, you know, sure, they've traded away some veteran players and they've traded away some guys that really made this team great, but I think they did a decent job filling those holes, and I think Doug Marrone and Dave Caldwell's influence on this offseason has been apparent, and hopefully Caldwell can have a good draft because he has a lot of draft picks, and he needs to make good with that. So, speaking of that, also, me and Chance from Yo Chance Fitness are going to be making a mock draft, a 7-round mock draft for the Jacksonville Jaguars. That should be out on Saturday night. And that was grading all the Jaguars free agency signings. What'd you guys think? Leave your comments down below. Don't forget to check the links down below as well. You can like me on Facebook at Treeb Talks. Follow me on Twitter at Treeb Talks or follow me on Instagram at Trey Vaughn Pixley. Also, make sure you hit that subscribe button. Click the bell icon so you get notified every single time I drop a new video. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. And as always, you guys have a great rest of your day.